Good morning, students. So welcome back to your chemistry class. So last class we discussed about the law of conservation of energy. We just started the third chapter, atoms and molecules, and under this atoms and molecules we discussed about the law of conservation of mass. Did you remember all this? The law of conservation of mass, law of constant proportion, etc. And today we are going to discuss about the terms atoms and molecules. Atoms and molecules, the chapter name itself. Did you hear about the atoms? Atoms கேட்டிட்டு இருந்தீங்களா? So atoms means a cell. Human body la cell எங்கனேயானோ the same way atom in a substance. So cell means it is the basic unit of a human body. Alle life, the cell is the basic unit of a life ennu parayunnathu pole, when you consider any matter and when you consider any substance, when you consider anything, and the atom is the basic unit of that, and we cannot see the atoms by our naked eyes. This is very small enough and this is beyond our imagination. So when you consider this one, this is a chalk, isn't it? And when I took the very smallest portion of this chalk, and atom is very much smaller than this. That means an atom is very small enough and beyond our imagination. We cannot predict the size of an atom by using meter, centimeter, etc. For that, in order to designate the size of an atom, we use the certain units are we depend nanometer, picometer, angstrom, etc. That much small enough atom. So what is atom? Atom is a basic unit of anything, and there is very small enough, and they can be measured and can be designated by means of a certain units. They are nanometer, picometer, angstrom, etc. So these are the normal spellings of that. So this nanometer, picometer, angstrom will be normally used to designate the size of an atom. So what is nanometer? The 1 meter is equal to 10^-9 nanometer. 1 meter is equal to 10^-12 picometer, 10^-10 angstrom. So these are the units that we normally used to designate the size of an atom. What are they? Nanometer, picometer, angstrom. What is it? Nanometer, picometer, angstrom. Angle oru paar undu nanu just moonanam paranjane ullu. Nanometer, picometer, itra mathram cherudana nammude atom enna just make you understand. Okay, so this is atom. Atom is the basic unit of anything, and which is normally expressed by means of these three units mainly. Now we are moving on to the next session. Next session means this continuing session, atomic mass. What is atomic mass? Simply, it is a mass of an atom. What it is? Simply, it is a mass of an atom. Simply, it is a mass of an atom. So mass of an atom is known as atomic mass. Nowadays there is a lot of sophisticated methods are there to measure the atomic mass nowadays, but earlier the scientists faced so difficulties to measure or to determine the atomic mass of an element or an atom, and for that they took a lot of methods to measure the atomic mass. So let's discuss atomic mass. Atomic mass. So this atomic mass, in order to determine the atomic atomic mass of an element or an atom, the scientist had take a reference standard. Take a reference standard. Reference standing. So what do you mean by reference standing? ഒരാളെ വെച്ചുകൊണ്ട് മറ്റൊരിനത്തിനെ നമ്മൾ മെഷർ ചെയ്യുന്നതിനെയാണ് റഫറൻസ് സ്റ്റാൻഡേർഡ് എന്ന് പറയുന്നത്. സോ ഇനിഷ്യലി ദ സയന്റിസ്റ്റ് ഹാഡ് ടേക്കൺ ഓക്സിജൻ 16. ഓക്സിജൻ 16. ഓക്സിജൻ അറ്റോമിക് മാസ 16 വുഡ് ബി ടേക്കൺ ആസ് എ റഫറൻസ് സ്റ്റാൻഡേർഡ്. അതായത് ഓക്സിജന്റെ മാസ് വെച്ചുകൊണ്ട് ബാക്കിയുള്ള എല്ലാവരുടെയും മാസ് പറയുന്നത് ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് ഗോയിങ് ടു ബി റഫറൻസ് സ്റ്റാൻഡേർഡ്. ആൻഡ് this oxygen is selecting for the as a reference standard only because of oxygen is highly present in atmosphere and they are always ready to react with any type of element, and that is the reason. Okay, that's why oxygen is selected as a reference standard. And if you don't understand what is reference standard, I will give one example for you. When you consider a fruit seller is there to sell the fruits, and but he don't have the weights are not there. That means 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg, nothing. So only he cut a watermelon is there. He cut this watermelon into 12 pieces. Based on these 12 pieces, he sold the fruit. That means when a person who came to him and asked for mangoes or guava or grapes, anything, and he took this watermelon as a weigh, watermelon to weigh the other fruits also. He cut this watermelon into 12 pieces. Then a person who came near and they told them to bring mangoes with respect to these 2 pieces of watermelon. 2 piece of watermelon da 3 mango da illengil 2 pieces of watermelon da 3 guava ingane parayunu adha nammal ennu parayunnathu give 1 kg 2 kg 3 kg so nothing is there, and he took the watermelon as a reference standard. That means with respect to watermelon he gave the other fruits, with respect to watermelon he weighed the other fruits. The same way earlier initially the scientist had took a reference standard to determine the mass of an atom. Initially which one will be taken as a reference standard? Oxygen 16 will be taken as a reference standard. But it is cancer, it will be changed into carbon 12 because carbon 12 is more convenient, and that's why carbon 12 is taken as a reference standard. Based on this carbon 12 isotope or atomic mass of this carbon 12 isotope, the scientists succeeded to find out the atomic masses of other elements also, and he gave the term atomic mass unit. What it is? One atomic mass unit. One atomic mass unit. One atomic mass unit. So what is one atomic mass unit? One atomic mass unit is the mass unit which is equal to 1 by 12th of mass of carbon 12 isotope. Any element whose mass can be represented by means of 1 by 12th of the mass of carbon 12 isotope. ഏത് element ആണോ ആ element നെ ഏതൊരു atom ആണോ ആ ഏതൊരു atom തേയും അതിന്റെ mass carbon 12 isotope isotope mass in the 1 by 12. This is known as a atomic mass unit. So one atomic mass unit is what? And it is the mass unit which is equal to 1 by 12 of the mass of a carbon 12 isotope. Carbon 12 isotope. So this is 1 amu or 1 atomic mass unit. 1 amu or 1 atomic mass unit. Okay, understood all of you? Or idea kittilo? That means an atomic mass is normally measured or normally find or predicted by using a reference standard. Normally using the scientist had fixed a reference standard which is carbon 12 isotope. Based on this, and they give the definition for one atomic mass unit. One atomic mass unit is the mass unit which is equal to 1 by 12th of the mass of carbon 12 isotope. Understood? Okay. Understood? Okay, so by nowadays the methods are there to find out the atomic mass of any element. Either element in day in the atomic mass find out the chain. Okay, so based on these studies and their theories and their discoveries, and he found the atomic masses of almost all the elements. And for your syllabus, you have to study the atomic masses of certain elements which had given in your textbook, and I will write over here, and this is very important for you. So atomic masses of certain elements, I'm going to write here. So they are first one hydrogen, then carbon, nitrogen, oxygen, then I will write over here, sodium, magnesium, sulfur, chlorine, calcium. So these are the elements and whose atomic masses you should study. This is given in your syllabus. So afterwards, for your 10th standard, you are able to study the remaining ones. So first one is hydrogen. Its atomic mass is 1. What is atomic mass? 1. Carbon is 12. Nitrogen 14. Oxygen 16. Sodium 23. Magnesium 24. Sulfur 32. Chlorine 35.5. Calcium 14. So these are the atomic masses that you have to by heart. These are the elements of atomic masses of certain elements in your syllabus, and I will tell once. Hydrogen atomic mass is 1, carbon atomic mass is 12, nitrogen it is 14, oxygen it is 16, sodium it is 23, magnesium 24, sulfur 32, chlorine 35.5, calcium 14. Once more. Hydrogen atomic mass is 1, carbon atomic mass is 12, nitrogen atomic mass is 14, oxygen atomic mass is 16, sodium atomic mass is 23, magnesium is 24, sulfur 32, chlorine 35.5, and calcium is 14. So this is the atomic masses of certain elements. So today we discussed only about the very small portion, atom atomic mass. I am going to wind up the class, today's class. Only because of this is very important one. That means you have to study this topic clearly. So that's why I'm going to wind up. Otherwise, I will take the next portion, that is molecule. Okay. So I will take the molecule and about the molecular mass on the next class. That make sure before attending the coming class, you make sure you should study, you will study these atomic mass. That much important this one. So what should we discuss today? Atomic mass, atom. Atom is the basic unit of anything, and the mass of an atom is said to be atomic mass. And the atomic mass is normally, earlier it is found out by using carbon 12 isotope as a reference standard, and afterwards methods are there, techniques are there to find out the atomic masses and certain atomic masses of certain elements had given in your textbook, and I had also right here over I brought here also, so you should study all this. Okay, and if you have any doubt regarding the topic, and we will discuss. Okay, so hope all you understand today's topic. This is very important one. So stay safe, stay healthy, and stay happy. Thank you all of you.